Good morning, children. We are in the 12th lesson, the Kakatiya's emergence of regional kingdom. Okay, this is the 7th class social studies. So I said, who are the Kakatiya rulers? Among them, who are the important persons? Rudrama Devi. She was very important ruler in Kakatiya kingdom. She fought bravely. Who were the enemies? Who revolted against her, and how she established the kingdom and how she ruled the kingdom, etc. Now, in this lesson, the remaining part, look at once. Here, they appointed, actually, what is the main source of this kingdom? The main source of this kingdom is income. How the income will come? Through taxes. Through taxes. So they laid taxes upon agricultural productivity and also upon trade, who are trading, that means the businessmen, etc. Listen, for this purpose they appointed some members to collect the tax in village areas. So who are the warriors, who are the soldiers, who are efficient workers? So they appointed as Naikas. They appointed as Naikas. These Naikas going to every village and collect. They appointed in that village also Nayankaras. So this is called Nayankara system. So in this Nayankara system, what is the main activity here? Collecting tax from agriculture product. From agriculture product. So who collected and who introduced this system? Mainly in Kakatiyas, two persons or two kings are important. First one is Rudrama Devi. So Rudrama Devi dressed herself as king. Okay, next to Pratapa Rudra. So Pratapa Rudra and Rudrama Devi, they appointed this system. What is that? Nayankara system. So who are the skilled warriors? Who are the skilled warriors under this king and queen? They appointed to collect the tax. About army, actually that is the main income of this kingdom. That is the main income of the kingdom. Next one, king and queen. So sometimes who are under king and queen, they are rebellion against king and queen. So cleverly, these Rudrama Devi and Pratap Rudra suppressed them, subdued them. Okay. So next one, agriculture, not only agriculture activities. They encouraged agriculture activities. How they encouraged agriculture activities? For expansion of agriculture activities, they started construct tanks. What are that? Tanks. Tanks means cherubulu. Okay, cherubulu. Because our South India land is very suitable for construction of tanks. So at the rainy season, due to the rainfall, we have so much, that means sufficient water. Okay, after rainy season we need that water for agriculture purpose and animal drinking and also domestic purpose, etc. Okay, but that is why they wanted to store the water through this activity. What is that here? Tanks. Okay, especially we can see almost every village the tanks, one or two tanks. So the Kakatiyas built many tanks in Telangana region and also Rayalaseema region. I said in this lesson, okay, in the previous class, our AP now also three regions. What are the three regions? Coastal region, Telangana region, Rayalaseema region. But recently, 4 years or 5 years ago, Telangana bifurcated from our AP state. So it formed as a new state, Telangana state. Okay, so remain two states as our AP state. That is, there first is coastal and also Rayalaseema. So these two are now present to our AP state. Okay, so they encouraged to build these tanks in Telangana region and also Rayalaseema region. Why? Because these areas are suitable for constructing the tanks. Next one, why they constructed these tanks? To expand the agricultural activity almost in all area in that village areas. Okay, when the people are, when farmers extended their agricultural activity, they can yield more product than the previous years with the help of this irrigation water through tanks. Okay, Neeru Katte Manishi, I said already, who are one man was appointed to look after and to supply this tank water to the agricultural land. That man name is Neeru Katte Manishi or Nerati. What his name? Nerati. Next one, they encouraged to build temples also, not only tanks but also temples, because in our area on those days the Hinduism, that means idols, they gave more importance to construct temples. How they construct these temples? In the royal family, who are queen, king, next to relatives, next landlords, okay, so who are prominent people in that kingdom, so they encouraged to build temples in that areas, almost all areas. Okay, even women also, the royal family women also encouraged, so they gave gifts or offerings. Okay, a big amount they gave as offering to construct temples in that region or kingdom. For example, here I wrote to woman name here, Muppamamba. What her name? Muppamamba and Mallamma. Muppamamba and Mallamma. So they gave their money to construct temples in that area, and also they gave land also, which is the suitable place or which is the suitable land in their region or kingdom. So they constructed, for the construction of temples, they offered or they gave the land. Muppamamba and Mallamma. Next one, in this period, trade is very important one. So through trade also, that means who are trading by overseas. Overseas means they are trading not only within the country but also in other countries and other kingdoms. So far countries, overseas means through seas and oceans. Okay, through this way, who are dealing or who are trading, these kings are laid tax over the traders. Through these activities, they got some tax or income, okay, to support the administration of their kingdom. Next one, they constructed ports also. So how can we know they constructed or they laid tax upon the traders? So they laid some stones. In that stone they wrote inscriptions. That is called inscriptions. That means Shasanamalu. Okay. So Appati Rajulu Shasanalu Veyinchevadu. Okay. Aa Shasanalo they wrote about their information. That means what did they do? So they mentioned in that inscriptions. If we read that all inscriptions, then we can know about their ruling, about their activities, what they did or how they fought against enemies, etc. So inscriptions. Next one, on those days one port was very famous port. That port name was Motupalli. What was that? Motupalli port was very famous. Through Motupalli port, the traders are moving their goods and they are exporting and importing. Okay, over these activities they laid tax. Next one, who built this port or who established this port? Here, Ganapati Deva. Ganapati Deva was established this Motupalli port at the time of Kakatiya kingdom, at the time of Kakatiya rulers. Ganapati Deva. Who? Ganapati Deva established Motupalli port. Next one, we know about the history of these all kings in Kakatiya kingdoms through inscriptions. Through inscriptions, they encouraged Sanskrit language and also Telugu language. Sanskrit language and also Telugu language. Next one, on those days one Italian traveler was there. His name was Marco Polo. What his name? Marco Polo. So he wrote about the kingdom and also about the trade. Okay. So main things are main goods are diamonds. So diamonds are very precious one. So they are exporting from this Motupalli port and also getting profit. Next one, delicate cloth. So it is also one of the important cloth exporting from our Kakatiya kingdom. Next one, the end of this Kakatiya kingdom. End of this Kakatiya kingdom. 1190 AD, new kingdom was established by Sultan Singh Delhi. Sultan Singh Delhi. New Delhi, now New Delhi, but those is the two, old Delhi. Okay. Next, who these all people, they came from Turkestan. They came from Turkestan and occupied the North India. Okay, they ruled from New Delhi or Delhi. Okay. Next one, among them, one famous man, Muhammad bin Tughlaq. What his name? Muhammad bin Tughlaq defeated Prataparudra, the Kakatiya, one of the ruler. Prataparudra was defeated by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, who was ruling from Delhi. They are sultans. They are sultans. They came from Turkestan. Okay. So that is why he was defeated through this activity the Kakatiya kingdom was formed. Okay. Next one, 1323 at the same area, that means Karnataka area, another two powerful kingdoms came up. Okay. That means Bahamanis and also Vijayanagara kingdom. Bahamani and also Vijayanagara kingdom came. After fall of or after end of this Kakatiya kingdom, so we can see two kingdoms, Bahamani and also Vijayanagara kingdom in South India. So one of the famous kingdom is Kakatiya kingdom. Okay, now students listen, I want to show you some pictures about this lesson.
Now gold coin issued by Kakatiyas. Look at the gold coin. Even nowadays we are using the gold coins. Paper money also we are using. Introduced by Reserve Bank of India, by the central government, like that. Next I said about inscription, Shasanamulu. Look at that inscription. Motupalli pillar inscription, this is. So the Motupalli port was built by, I said already, Ganapati Deva. Through this port, the export and imports are doing. Next, listen students, this is one of the remain of great temple dedicated to Shiva. So these are the pillars. Next students, once look at this picture, a segment of the inner earthen wall with its dry mount at right. So this is the earthen wall. Inside is the city or kingdom or capital. This is the earthen wall for the protection. So this is the port. Aerial view of the eastern gateway in the city's inner stone wall, showing the bent entrance, Vankadari in Telugu, and open country yard, Anganam. The doorway at right in the great city gate. Look, this is, and this is. Leading to the Royal Avenue, Raja Markambu. Next, listen students. Now once again look at this picture. Rudramadevi riding the horse. Rudramadevi riding the horse. I said in the Kakatiya rulers, she was very famous and brave woman. She suppressed and she subdued many Nayakas under his control. Next, this is Kirti Torana, entrance of Swayambhu Shiva temple built by Kakatiyas kings in Warangal. Look at this, children. It is also look like our CRDA. When Chandrababu Naidu was CM, that means former minister through Tulluru. So this is, once again you also look at what are the index, outer rampart, mouth, inner rampart, stone wall, etc. Next, here the timeline also given. Important king Kakatiya rulers, Prola II, Rudradeva, Ganpati Deva, Rudramadevi, Prataparudra. So these are the main kings in this Kakatiya kingdom and their periods also given. For example, Rudramadevi 1262 to 1289 AD. Pratapurudra 1289 to 1323 AD. Okay children, this is our lesson. After this you read the textbook and observe the pictures. Then you take your material and read the important points. Thank you.